Welcome everyone to today's tutorial on how to rig a car in Unreal Engine 5. If you're looking to bring a car into Unreal 5 and ensure its proper functionality, you've come to the right place. This comprehensive tutorial will walk you through the step-by-step setup process, equipping you with the knowledge and skills necessary to successfully rig a car in Unreal Engine 5. So, without any further delay, let's dive right in. To import your mesh into Unreal Engine, start by organizing your files. Create a new folder in the content browser by right-clicking and selecting New Folder. Within this folder, either right-click and choose Import to /game or drag your FBX file directly from your PC. Ensure that the Skeletal Mesh option is selected. If everything is in order, you will have three assets: the mesh, the skeleton, and the physical asset. Importing your mesh into Unreal Engine has never been easier. To get started, open the physics asset and select All Wheels Collision Bodies. Make adjustments to the primitive types by setting them to sphere and then regenerate the bodies. Next, choose Body Collision and change the primitive type to Multi-Convex Hull. Once again, regenerate the bodies. This step is crucial if you want your control rig to interact with props in your cinematics. It is important to ensure proper collision bounds for optimal results. To get started, simply right-click on the skeletal mesh and choose the option to create control rig. Next, let's dive into programming the control rig by accessing the control rig asset. In this asset, we have the bone structure for our car, which includes the root for the body and individual bones for each wheel: back left, back right, front left, and front right. These specific names were set up in Cinema 4D for seamless integration. To start, let's create the control for the root element. Simply right-click on the root and select New Control. This control will manage the tilting of the car's body. To rename it, press F2 or right-click and rename it to Body Control. Next, we'll proceed with the creation of the wheel rotation control. You can create this control anywhere, but for ease, let's create it from the wheel itself. Rename it as Wheel Rotation. Lastly, we'll move on to creating the steering control. To proceed, we need to create a new null object that will act as our control. This null object should not be linked to any car bone or existing control to avoid any potential functionality issues. Please exercise caution. Right-click on an empty area that is not associated with a bone or other control and select New Null. Let's name it Control Space. This step is crucial for smooth operation and proper control of your project. To organize your controls effectively, start by selecting all of them and dragging them under the newly created control space. Next, customize the colors of each control. You can set the body to blue, rotation to yellow, and steering to green. Feel free to choose your preferred colors. Once you've done that, select the body control and drag it onto the node graph. Then, choose Get Control and drag the root bone onto the node graph. Finally, select Add Offset to add a relative offset to the root bone. We only need to feed rotation to the body. Expand the transform pin on both nodes and connect only the rotation. Test it by dragging the forward to solve output to the execute of the offset the transform. Next, select the body control and attempt to rotate it. You'll notice that it functions correctly without affecting the wheels. To ensure this, uncheck the Propagate to Children box. Test it again and witness the excellent results. The transformation now works perfectly. Let's create a steering control for optimal results. Start by dragging the steering control to the node graph and selecting Get Control. Then, expand the transform and translation options. We will use movement along the Y-axis to steer the wheels effectively. Drag the Y pin and search for the multiply node. Set the B value to 0.35 for optimal performance. Finally, locate the From Euler node and connect the result of the multiply node to Z for seamless integration. To set up the steering for our car, begin by selecting the two bones representing the front left and front right wheels. Drag these bones to the node graph and choose Add Offset from the selection. Expand the offset transform pins and connect the rotation results from the Euler node. Next, drag the execute pin from the previous controls to the wheels. Remember to connect all offset control execute pins to ensure both wheels turn smoothly. To improve the cleanliness of our control rig, let's create a sequence node. This node will determine the order of transforms, starting with the body, then the steering, and finally, the wheel rotation. If, for any reason, the initial position of your wheels is not straight, please review the control details and ensure there are no offsets on the Y axis. I had to reset it on my car. Enhancing control, rig cleanliness through a sequence node, and addressing potential wheel alignment issues. With these adjustments, we can easily maneuver and control our car's steering. Depending on the orientation of your vehicle on the X axis, you may need to use -0.35 for the B value, as shown here. Once you've set the initial wheel position, I'll provide comments to enhance the overall appearance. Simply right-click in the node graph window and select Get Control Float from the drop-down menu. Then choose the wheel rotation control option and connect the float value pin to a multiply node. After conducting tests, I found that a value of 50 yields the best results. Follow these steps to optimize your controls and achieve the desired appearance. Add another multiply node. Simply drag the B value pin and input half pi. Afterward, find the accumulated time node. Create an Euler node and connect the Y axis of the accumulated time node to the Euler node. This ensures smooth and efficient calculation flow. To set up the rig, start by dragging all four wheel bones into the node window. Next, select Add Offset and expand the offset transform for each bone. Finally, connect the resulting offsets to the rotation of each bone. Now, let's organize the rig and add an additional pin to the sequence node. Connect all elements in the rotation graph to gain control over acceleration, reverse, steering, and body tilt for all wheels simultaneously. Optimize your rig setup for efficient performance and enhanced control. While the current setup enables immediate animation, I recommend enhancing the rig with additional shapes and limits to enhance visual appeal and facilitate smoother animation. To modify a control, simply select it and choose the desired shape. You can adjust the size of the shape as needed. In addition, I made a change to the control type for the body, setting it to rotator in order to restrict rotation in the sequencer. This modification simplifies usage and enhances the overall experience. Furthermore, I have defined limits for the min and max values, ranging from -3 to 3. By implementing control shapes and limits, the car body will remain within its boundaries, regardless of the extent of rotation. Explore these optimized features for an improved user experience. Afterward, I established defined ranges for steering controls, which span from -50 to 50. For wheel rotation, it is crucial to select the appropriate transformed position type, enabling easy dragging back and forth. The limits for wheel rotation on the X-axis are set at -20 to 20. Once these adjustments are made, simply click on Compile and Save to finalize the changes. Finally, to ensure proper rotation of the calipers, just uncheck the Propagate to Children option in the wheel rotation rig. That's all it takes. Test it out to ensure smooth and accurate rotation and steering. Hit Compile, and your car is now ready to be animated within Unreal Engine. Thank you for watching my comprehensive tutorial on car rigging in Unreal Engine. If you found this video helpful and informative, I would greatly appreciate your support by liking, subscribing, and sharing it with others. Stay tuned for more exciting content coming your way.